Hare Krishna. See, Navadvip Prabhu, to speak something. Why I have come and where I am coming.
First of all, offer my dhanavad pranam to my Gurudev Shishimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj and also to all the assembled Vaishnavas and guests. So, I've known Srila Narayan Maharaj for 6 years now, from the time that I first went to Vrindavan. And during the whole time that I've known him, I never imagined that he would come to the West. And neither did he ever give any indication that he would do such a thing. Because he is so deeply immersed in the mood of Vraj, and the residents of Braj. And there he is daily giving Harikatha, speaking on the glories of the love of Shishi Radha and Krishna. And all of the local devotees and residents there, they are very, very much attached to his association. And it is very difficult for them to tolerate, even when he goes out of Braj for a short time, to go to Navadvip Dham or Jagannath Puri. So it was unimaginable to them or to me or practically to anyone who knows Srila Narayan Maharaj that he would leave and come to the West. And certainly there was no desire on his part that he would come here for any personal motive. But rather, it is the indication has come from his Ishtadev, his worshipable deity, Srimati Radhika, and also Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as well as the order of his Gurudev, Sri Srimad Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Goswami Maharaj, and his Shiksha Guru, Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, that he should come to the West. And he has come solely to fulfill the mission which was taken up by Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, which is the same mission which was given to him by his Gurudev, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And also the same mission of all our acharyas, Srila Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, going back to Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So it is on the order of all of our acharyas in disciplined succession, and in particular, the order of his Gurudev and Srila Swami Maharaj Prabhupada, that he has now come to the West at this time to fulfill the very mission which they dedicated their lives towards. And it is significant also that he has come in this year, which is the centennial year of Srila Prabhupada. Just as Srila Prabhupada was fully surrendered to carrying out the order which was given to him by his Gurudev, and yet he had no idea exactly how that would transpire. And yet the Lord made all arrangements, and he came just at a particular time and to a particular place where he would have the most success. He came to New York in 1965, and the field was very ripe for him to distribute Krishna consciousness to the whole world. But he did not plan this by his own intelligence. All arrangements were made by his worshipful deities, Shishi Radha Krishna and his Gurudev. for him to come at that particular time. So similarly, although Srila Narayan was not planning to come here, all arrangements were made by Srila Prabhupada for him to come, especially at this time, to fulfill his mission. So the significance is that Srila Prabhupada wanted all of his followers, whom he gave the seed of Krishna consciousness to actually attain the real essence of what he came to give. And perhaps if Srila Narayan Maharaj had come at another time, the field would not have been so ripe. But now it has been some 20 years after Srila Prabhupada's departure, and the devotees have matured in their Krishna consciousness. They have been starving for so many years. They've seen so many setbacks and anomalies that have taken place within the movement for Krishna consciousness. They have been suppressed in so many ways and discouraged from thinking for themselves. But now they have experienced all these things, and they can judge for themselves what is something very valuable, what is inspiring for their Krishna consciousness. So our Gurudev, Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj, has come at this time, and I have witnessed on this tour the transformation that has taken place in so many devotees' lives, how they have become renewed and re-inspired in their Krishna consciousness, how they have felt through his association, the association of Swami Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, how their enthusiasm for advancing in Krishna consciousness has become awakened simply by meeting him and hearing from him Harikatha. So the real mission for which Srila Prabhupada worked so hard for so many years is to give the essence of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings, of the teachings of Rupa Goswami, and that is Ragmayi Bhakti, which is leading to Vraj. And that type of bhakti has to be awakened in the association of persons who are tasting that within their hearts. The symptoms of Ragmayi Bhakti are described in Srila Rupa Goswami's Bhaktirasamrita Sindhu. So there it is said, Ragatmikaika Nishta Ye Vrajavasi Janadishu Tesham Bhava Paya Lubdo Bhavet Patradi Karavan. That the qualification for obtaining that type of bhakti, which is the eternal condition which is naturally situated in the hearts of the Lord's eternal associates, the ragatmika bhaktas of the Lord, the qualification for pursuing that type of bhakti, tesham bhav apaye lubdo, is greed to obtain that. And what are the symptoms of that greed? Tattad bhavat adhima bhaje shruti giriyat apekshate natra shatran nayuktam cha tallo prati lakshanam. The symptoms of that greed are that when one hears of these sweet moods and loving devotion of the residents of Braj, either from the books of the Goswamis or by the person who is describing such moods, when one intelligence becomes captivated by that and no longer dependent on the reasonings or logical arguments of Shastra, that is the symptom of the awakening of such greed. So in my own experience of trying to practice Krishna consciousness, although I had studied and read many times Chaitanya Charitamrita, where these things are described, and also Nectar Devotion, Although some little inspiration would be there, but I never directly experienced that my consciousness became possessed of a very intense desire to strive for that in my spiritual life. Rather, I could understand that the motivation or the impetus for my attempt to practice bhakti was the Shastra. The Shastra is saying, you should do this. If you don't do this, you will be degraded. If you do this, you will obtain a favorable result. So on the basis of Shastra, I was convinced that I should perform bhakti. That is called Vaidhi Bhakti. But I never experienced that the motivation or impetus for my engagement in bhakti was an intense greed to obtain that same type of devotion which is possessed by the Lord's eternal associates. And yet that is the very thing which Mahaprabhu came to give us. But until I came in contact with Srila Narayan Maharaj, this understanding never came to me. So my practical realization, and not only practical realization, but it is also the statement of the Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam Taranam Aswado Rasikai Saha Sajatya Shaye Snigde Radao Sanga Svato Bare, that we should hear Srimad Bhagavatam, not only hear, but taste the meaning. Artha Aswad means to taste the meaning. And Rasikai Saha means with the help or with the assistance of Rasik Bhaktas. This is Rupa Goswami's statement. So if we want to enter into Srimad Bhagavatam, we must hear under the direction, under the guidance of a person who is personally realized and tasting the meaning, and then it can be revealed to us. And Sajati Ashayasnik De Sadhav Sangasvatobare. We must associate with sadhus who are more advanced, who are soft-hearted, and who are like-minded. So, this is the statement of the Shastra, and it is my personal realization in my own spiritual life, that without this type of association, this kind of understanding, or the inspiration to hanker for that type of bhakti, in other words, the bhakti which is possessed by the residents of Braj, it never awoken. It was never awoken in my heart. And by the guidance of Srila Narayan Maharaj, by continuously hearing his sweet Harikatha, and also by his personal example, seeing how he deals with everyone, he is capable of inspiring everyone for this type of bhakti. So certainly he has come on the order of Srila Prabhupada in order to fulfill his mission. And he is appealing to everyone on a very individual and personal level to help them to advance in Krishna consciousness, to help them aspire for this goal. So we urge all of you to simply hear with an open heart, and to be receptive to this message. And if you do so, you will receive great inspiration for your advancement in Krishna consciousness. Gaura Premananda.
Jnana Tirandhasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chaturun Vihitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah Vanchakalpatarubhyasya Kripasindhubhyaiva cha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namo Mahabhadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayati Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanana Gauratishe Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaste. तप्त कंचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वान्विते प्रणमामि हरि यं प्रपृजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत दीपायनो विरहकातरया जुहा पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदो तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमां तुष्णीम्। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि शिवगुरुभक्त हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे राम राम राम।
ऑफरिंग माय लैक्स लैक्स ओबेसियंसेस इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय डिवाइन ग्रेस नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद् भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज एंड माय शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद् भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज। हाउ आई केम टू वेस्टर्न कंट्री श्री नवदीप प्रभु हैज टोल्ड। सो आई डोंट वांट टू रिवाइज अगेन बट आई वांट टू टेल दैट आई वाज पेनीलेस लाइक स्वामी जी व्हेन ही came to Western countries. He came with a kartal and his Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, some parts. And in very short time he has preached our Vedic culture and Vedic knowledge, especially Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. In whole for established so many temples, writing so many books in about 40 languages of whole world. He has ordered me to come when he was coming first in Western countries. But at that time I was serving my Gurudev, so could not come. But anyhow he has managed to come here. First of all I want to tell that I don't know English so much. My English is very poor and so lame. But in Hindi, Bengali and all other Indian languages, I can speak freely, expressing my whole moods in them. When I came here, then I learned something to speak. Otherwise, in India, I could not try to speak in English. So, I think that it will be very poor, but yet I am trying to speak in English because I am seeing that all the audience here know English and especially their Western countries people. Very little Indian people. So, especially I came to Western country to take the feet dust of Swamiji, where he came first, and after Los Angeles, Houston, he has come also in San Francisco, He also lost in New York, in London, Manor, and so many places. In Australia, in so many places. So I thought that if he is manages to come to Western countries, I should take the first trust, because where he has gone, all the places have become so much Tirtha, sacred places. I know that the places we are called sacred, they are not sacred if there are no Vaishnava. So, Vrindavan is so sacred, but if there are no any bona fide Rashi and Bhav Bhakta, then it is not so powerful. So where the feet dust of any bona fide Vaishnava and having so much powerful energy from his holy master and Radha Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, certainly this is a very sacred place. So first my mission was to take the feet dust of Swamiji and to realize how in a very little time he spread all these missions everywhere. What is Ved? What is Gita? What are the Upanishads? And what are the essence of all these things? In a very, very simple words, not philosophical so words, very simple words. We know that Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all the Vedas, Puran, Upanishad, Smriti, Shruti, Gita, everything. Nigamakalpatarurgalitanaphalam sukamukhad amritravasanjutam pivat bhagavatam rasamalayam moraho rasika bhubibhavka. The third or fourth shloka, third shloka perhaps. Very important shloka. He has told me. You should know that Parikshit Maharaj was a very learned king, emperor. He was so powerful. He was so learned. You can know his glorification by this, that Krishna has taken him in his laps and he has sacked Parikshit Maharaj in the womb of his mother and always protected. Sukadeva Goswami and Vyasa have known so fortunate that Krishna can take them in his lap. So he was not less than Sukadeva Goswami or Vyasa or Narada. I think he was so much fortunate than them also, because he was very fast, near and dear relation to Krishna. So, one day he went out for hunting or anywhere he was going, and he became so thirsty. He came to a rishi and told that, "I want to take water. I'm so thirsty." He was in Samadhi, you know Samadhi. Body is here, but mind and heart were within the lotus feet of Krishna. Not here. So he could not know that who has come and what he is telling. So he could not give water. And they came, become angry that I have come to his hut, and he is not welcoming me. and not giving butter. How is this age? Like in these days. So, he took a serpent and gave him his neck 3 times. And he went away. In the meantime, his son, only the age of 5, he heard that anyone has given serpent his neck, though it was dead serpent, he saw this, and he became angry. Who had done this? Now the wealthy person, those who are kshatriyas, they think to be emperor of the whole world and controller. Now they have forget Sanatana Dharma. They are thinking that we are monarch of all, we are controller. But they don't know that they are the dogs serving the kitchen of Thakurji. They should think this, that we are dogs to save. But now they have become master. So I gave a lesson to him. And saying so, naked boy of 5, yes. And he took some water and cursed him. After 7th day, the serpent will come and bite you. Anyone cannot save you. And he began to weep, sitting in the laps of his father. After some time, the father awoke from samadhi. Oh, why you are crying and weeping? Oh, father, see, anyone has given this air serpent in your neck? Why you cursed him? He asked his boy. You are not Brahmin. Brahmin should be tolerant. They have this quality that they have to tolerate. But you have no patience to tolerate. You are not Kshatriya. You are not Brahmin. But you are a son of Brahmin. You have done so wrong. He rebuked him. And then he called a student and told him to go to Parikshit Maharaja, tell that on 7th day a serpent will come and you will die. He will bite you and you must die. Anyone cannot save you. When he heard this, he became so happy. Instead of becoming, this is not a cause, but curse. But it is benediction. Krishna has come apparently to me. Because now I realize that we should do bhajan and try to realize that who am I? Why I have come to this world? Whole wealth of this Vishwa world cannot satisfy me. It cannot give me happiness. To anyone, you will have to leave this world in day or today. We should know that this body is not myself. My soul is eternal, part and parcels of Krishna. If anyone thinks this world and not realizing all the things, then he is like an animal, more than animals. So I wanted to do bhajan, to practice bhakti, but I was saying that, oh, from tomorrow I will do, again tomorrow I will begin bhakti. But I never did it. Now I have to give up everything my father, mother, wife, children, and kingdoms, and every wealth. And he put up his crown and royal dresses, and he sat down on the bank of sacred Ganges. In the meantime, in a moment, so many rishis like Vyas, Narad, Kabi Habi, Navjagendra, Gautam Vasishtha, all at once came from different parts of the whole world. He did pranam to all. At that time was no wireless or anything, nothing there was. But how they came? No use of aeroplane or anything. They can go to this world, that world, heaven, more than that. They can go to Vaikunth, Golok, Vrindavan, everywhere they can go. So at once they collected there. Srila Panchit Maharaj very honorably he requested to answer two questions. The persons who are dying at once, in a moment, they are lying down for death. What they should do? And the persons who are not dying, but they will die tomorrow or day after tomorrow, or in 100 years or 500 years, they must die. Even Brahma will have to die. What to tell of all these persons? So I want to know what they should do. So two prominent questions. A person who is dying just now, what he should do? And the persons who will die, those who have taken birth, they must die. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu dhruvam janma mrityasya cha. Gita, Bhagavad, Ved, Upanishad, all tell like this. Anyone can listen. In the meantime, all were telling that you should do samadhi, you should do dhyan, meditation, you should give charity, you should do this and that. In the meantime, Sukadeva Goswami came there. He was quite naked, aged about 16, and he was very happy. Some women clapping, seeing this mad person. They thought that he is a mad person, and clapping. Some joking, and boys, so many boys, they are pursuing him and taking the dust of earth and they take it like this. But when he came nearer, Parikshit Maharaj and all the members of these rishis, they stood up and they welcomed him. And they took him to the Divyashasana. And he apologized and then requested to answer the two questions. Then he told the person who died just now. Then he should take Krishna now, Ram now. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. If he cannot chant more, oh Krishna, Radhe, Radhe. If he cannot more, then he can feel Ram, Ram. If a man is going to stool, minutes stools, passing, loose motion and all other things. He is not sacred at that time, he has not taken bath, nothing. Only one Ram Nam will do, Narayana, like Ajamil. At once, he will be set from day, at once. And he can have salvation, more than that he can have Vaikuntha. And if his mode is to Ram, Aradharamana Ram, Aradharamana Hari Govinda Jaya. So Ram denotes Aradharamana Ram also. So if his mode is that, then he will go to Vrindavan. A tulsi, leaf of tulsi, Gangajal should be given to them. And he should speak Ram. If he cannot speak, then we can tell Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram. In his ears, and give for one drop of Charanamrit with tulsi. If he cannot take tulsi, you can have a tulsi and give here or keep here. It will do. Magically it will do. Like Valmiki, like Ajamin, like so many persons. It is so powerful. You know that, perhaps you don't know, that where Ram Nam is chanting, anyone, then Hanuman will come, surely Hanuman. He has legs and legs, mouth, he has legs and legs, ears, legs and legs, body, like Ram. And when he will tell Harikatha, the pastimes of Ram or Krishna, he will surely come. He may come in a body of very black person, also Kushta, leprosy, like leprosy persons, he will come. And he will say it in the last. And presently hear all these things. Once, Narada, while going anywhere, and he saw that a wild maker, Teli, always doing oil, doing making oil. He had no time to chant Ramna. Not all that you will have to go in hell. Why you are not chanting Ram? He told, I have no time at all. When you go to stall, what you do? Nothing. At that time you can do. So yes, from today I will do this. And he went to stall in the jungle and began to do Ram, Ram, Ram. At once Hanuman came and he saw that he is not sacred, he has not taken bath, and going to stall and taking Harinam. So he kicks very powerfully. But he was telling Ram Ram as if nothing had been done. When Hanuman used to give a kick to Ravan, he used to fell down on the earth, rolling on the earth, having taken mouth in his mouth, earth, dust. Also to Kumkan, he was more bigger than Ram. But he used to fall down. But for this person, nothing was done. He was astonished. Why? I have kicked him so powerfully, but he had no response. Thinking, he went to the palace of Ram in Ayodhya, and in night he saw that Ram was doing like, means feeling blank, everywhere. He went to Ram and did pranam and told that, "Oh Prabhu, why you are doing so? I think there is, must be some pain." He replied, "You have done this and you are coming to ask me that how it has come? You have kicked me so powerfully, my ears, something broken or not, I cannot say, but I have so much pain." He told that, "I have never kicked you, never, never, never. Oh, you know that my name and myself is same thing. Krishna and Krishna himself, they are not two, no difference at all. One thing. Moreover, we can tell that Krishna is more powerful than Krishna himself. Ram Nam is so powerful than Ram himself. Ram has liberated only few persons like Sabari and all others. But name is eternal. For all, Ram and Krishna cannot do kripa to any wretched person and those who are so much sinful. But name, for all it is so sulabh, easy. Anyone can do. A sadhu muni can do. Even a third class bogus person who is so much wretched and he is sinful. But yes, he can do Ramana and Krishna. So these are powerful. You know the history that when a bridge was going to make to go to Lanka, bridge was going on. And all the monkeys and bears bringing so much very big stones. And Nalil used to tell Hare Ram Ram and to touch, and they began to float on the water. Thus the bridge was constructing. When it was in the end, it was to be completed. Then Ram thought that all the monkeys giving these stones to Nalli and they are touching and telling Ram Ram and they are floating. I should try and I should examine that what becomes if I touch and fall in the sea. He went some far away in bushes. And he took a stone and he fell down, thrown in the sea. And it was sunk. In the meantime, Hanuman came, "Oh Prabhu, where you are? What you are doing?" He told that, "Why you came this time?" "I simply came." Hanuman told that, "I was seeing that where you are. I was searching you here and there. Because the bridge is completed and we should start for Lanka." Ram told that, "I was seeing that you all making the bridge, telling the name of Ram, my name, and keeping in the water and they are floating, but I took a stone and threw it out and it sank." Hanuman said, "No, nothing to worry, nothing to worry. Because we are chanting name and touching and they are floating. And if you will take anyone and throw out, you will not save him, no mercy to them, and you will throw out. Then they will surely, they will go down in the water so deep. What is that deep ocean? Endless sea of birth and death, sorrow and suffering. So that is stone. So the name of Krishna, the name of all the names are of Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama. All names are of Krishna. So they are so powerful. So he told that at once we should be try to tell that person that you should tell Krishna Krishna Hare Krishna. And if he cannot chant, then we should do in his ear, if we chant in his ear, he will accept from the death and all sufferings and sorrows. So he has told all these things in Valmiki, in Ajamir Upakhyan. And in the last he has done conclusion in 12th canto, at the last shloka. एतत् निर्विद्यमानानां इच्छतामकुतो भयं योगिनां निपनिर्णितं हरे नामानुकीर्तनम्. The essence of all the Vedas, Upanishad, is Krishna name. No doubt at all. And if anyone has some time, it is not certainty that he will die tomorrow or day after tomorrow or within 100 years or after that, then he should hear Srimad Bhagavatam. He should hear. And he should follow Nautha Bhakti. Like Prahlad Maharaj has told, Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Svaranam Pad Sivanam Archanam Bandanam Dasyam Sakkat Manivedanam. We should practice all these things. Krishna comes in the shape of Harikatha, pastimes, and it enters in our heart, makes our heart so clear, and he sits here. Sarnatang swakatha Krishna punya shravana kirtana hirdyantasto chapatrani budhano suhits. Krishna enters in the ears, those who are hearing the Harikatha, pastimes of Krishna, Ram. And it goes in the heart, clears the heart from six veg. Manaveg, krodhveg, jivveg, udarveg, upastveg, kam, krodh, lobh, mad, moh, masaj, all kinds of offense, all kinds of anartha, everything. He brooms the heart. And then he gives inspiration to hear Hari, to hear Harikatha more, like Parikshit Maharaj. So he has told that Savai Punsang Paro Dharmo Jato Bhakti Rathak Chaji Ahetukya Apratihata Jatma Samprasita. The religion of all the persons, human being and all the living beings, is to do bhakti of Krishna, the practice of bhakti. If they are not doing, then they are cutting their heads with their own knives. They are atmaghati. Nidehamadam sulabam sudurlabam plam sukalpam guru karnadar. Mayanukulan nabhasvate ritam kuman pavabdin na taretsa atma. Without any reason, Krishna has given this body human shape. And or this human shape is bona fide, strong, having two eyes, no rope, nothing, so powerful, intangible. He has given everything. But yet, we are not doing Hari Bhajan. Also Krishna has given Satguru. He has merged. And Anukul Vayu means Sadhu Sangha. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastra.
law matra sadhu sangha sarva siddhi hai. In moment, even in a moment, we will give in to sadhu sangha, he will cross all these things. So he is telling that if you are not doing bhajan, having this man, this human body, and the mercy of Krishna that he is managing sadhu sangha, like Swami ji, you have not invited him. He came first by his own mercy. He had not come from any penny or farthing and dollars. He had not come for reputations, nothing. Yet he came by his divine love, divine master's order and inspiration from Krishna himself. So Krishna manages everything. We cannot manage anything. So having all these things and we are not sincerely practicing bhakti yoga, then we are like self-killer. So he is telling, Nigama kalpatarur kalitang phalam sukamukhad amrit darshan yutam pivat bhagavatam rasamalayam muhurahau rasika bhubhavuka. You know that who was Sukadeva Goswami? He was the parrot of Srimati Radhika. A special parrot. She used to tell that parrot that you should tell Krishna, Krishna. It was so beautiful, that parrot. He used to tell Krishna, Krishna. In the same tune like Srimati Radhika. In melodious tone, Krishna, Krishna. She used to love that parrot, taking her hand and he used to do like this and giving him dudh anna or dudh, rice and milk with sugar or pomegranates, seeds, very beautiful and tasteful. He used to give. One day, he fly away from her hand and went very near from Barsana to Nandagaon, only 1-2 miles difference. Not two fingers. In a line. Here is Barsana, here is borders far. In Shake, have you been? You can know all these things. So he fly away and came to Nandagaon and sat on the tree, tamal tree. Tamal trees, collar and the pilot call, like shame, and he began to chant, Krishna, 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 Krishna. Krishna was playing with Madhusudan, Madhumangal there. And he heard the voice of Srimati Radhika. Oh, where Radhika? And she is calling, Krishna, Krishna. He sucked, look after here and there. He saw that there is the parrot sitting on the tamal tree and calling, Krishna, Krishna. He told them, again you should tell. Again he began. Krishna, Krishna. After that he read a slok. Then meaning of that slok. Oh, I was sitting on the hands of my beloved Master Srimati Radhika. And she was nourishing and supporting me.
and telling me, do Krishna, Krishna. But I am animal, I am bird. So I flew from her and came here. Now I am repenting. Why I came? Living by masters, very loving master. Why I came? I should not have come. And he was weeping and weeping. Krishna told, oh, come on, come on, come on. Very sweetly. And he was charmed and came on the hands of Krishna. Oh, again you should tell. What you are telling? Krishna, Krishna. And same thing, repeated. In the meantime, the friends of Srimati Radhika, Lalita and Vishakha came and told Krishna that, Krishna, these parotis of our Swamini Srimati Radhika, at once you should give me a return, and without this parot, she may die. So he should. He told, replied that if it is yours, then call, and if he goes, you should take her. They tried to call the parrot, but she never went. Srimati Radhika, Lalita Vishakha told, any person, any human being, any being, living being, who will go to you, they will come, never return. But if or suddenly he was here, Srimati Radhika was here, then if she will call, she will at once go. Krishna was not ready to give, and playing with Madhumangal and this. In the same time, they went to Yashodama and told that this parrot is of our Srimati Radhika, you should try to give us. Otherwise, she is so worried about that. Yashoda came at once and he took Krishna in his hand. What you are doing? Always with animals and birds, and you are doing so many nonsense things. And he catch hold this ear of Krishna and he took that bird and he took Krishna also and told that, oh, dear Sakis, try to bath Krishna. And they began to bath, and she took the bird and gave it to Lalita Vishakha. So this bird was not a common bird, ordinary bird, or any ordinary person. When Krishna and Srimati Radhika finished his pastimes in world, they began to return. Then they ordered this Suparo, Paro, that you will have to live here. Because we are all going, so you will have to help the all persons, Krishna Bhakti. And you will have to give Srimad Bhagavatam. You will have to manifest Srimad Bhagavatam in this world. Anyone cannot do this thing other than. So you must leave. He was so sorry and worried that how I can live without you. Oh, yes, you can live. And after doing all this task, you should return to me. So, Krishna and all these pastimes went to Golok Vrindavan in his Aprakat Leela. Even today, there is Vrindavan. Krishna never goes for a moment living Vrindavan. But anyone cannot realize. Only those who are rashik and liberated persons, they can realize all these things. So Sukhdeva, like in a shape of a person, he was in the shape of parrot. He went to Kailash, and hearing he was the same thing from Shankar, and Parvati was hearing. But when second chapter and third chapter, third canto came, and it was only how this creation has been done. He slept.
Then parrot was doing again, again, after this, hum, hum, like this. As Parvati was doing, in the same like Parvati. Shankar was seeing that, oh, Parvati is hearing Parvati. She went on going. When he ended Srimad Bhagavatam, Parvati awakened and told, I have not heard all the Bhagavatas. You should repeat. Then who heard? Who heard? Who was telling like you? Yes, yes, go on, go on. Who are you? He saw, looked here and there. At last he saw that there is a parrot sitting on the tree and hiding himself there. He took his threshold and he followed him. And he at once flew away and went to the ashram of Badrikashram, in the ashram of Vyasdev. And there Sukadeva Goswami came. Vyas was telling Harikatha and his wife Vitika was hearing the same Harikatha Krishna Srimad Bhagavatam. And he was astonished when Putna came and he wanted to kill Krishna. At first Krishna took his soul and also her life, and she became so big. And fell while she became, his shape was there, and crushed everything there. Then, hearing this, Vitika has, oh, he opened her mouth, and Sukadeva Goswami at once went her home. And he lived for 16 years there. And Vyas was telling all this katha, Ved, Upanishad, Shastra, everything she heard. Vyas said, although it is too late, you should come out. He said, I will not come in this Maya. What is Maya? What is Maya? He is my son, he is my father, he is my husband, he sees my wife, this wealth is mine, this body is myself. And related to me, everything is mine. And this is yours, this is yours. No relation with Krishna. This is called Maya. Maya. Ma mane no. Ya mane? The thing which is really there. We are only the son of Krishna. Part and parcel. Jivari Sarupa hai nitya Krishna da. But now you are think that I am lady, I am male, we are female, we are king, we are so scientist and all other things. So, this is called Maya. He told that I will not come in Maya. Oh, I am taking Maya from this world. For a moment, you should come out. I don't trust you. If Krishna will come and tell life, then I will come out. At once he prayed to Krishna and Krishna came and told, oh, you should come out, I am Krishna. I am taking Maya for a moment, and he at once came down. Krishna disappeared and he came and at once he left his father, mother and everything and went to forest. At that time he was persuading him, O son, ha putra, ha putra. He told them, who is putra? He, the jungle, the forest echoed. Who is son? Who is father? His relation or illusory. After some time, Vyas returned and he did Srimad Bhagavatam by the grace of Narada Rishi. And he was searching any person who is qualified for this Srimad Bhagavatam here. He thought that in this whole world only one qualified person is, and that is Sukadeva Goswami, my son died. How to return him? So he motes, he took his one shloka and told to hunters, those who are going to hunt animals. He told that if you will speak this word, chant this mantra, so many parrots and all birds and animals can you manage to have. And that shloka was Varahapidam natavarapaku karnayo karnikar vibhradavasah kanaka kapisham vajayanti shaham randhan venuradar sudhaya purayan gopavrindai vindarannam sabadaramanam pravishatagitak. In whole Srimad Bhagavata, even in soul, Veda and Upanishad, the beauty of Krishna is marvelous. There are none parallel shloka in anywhere. Sukadeva Goswami heard and at once charmed, and he prayed to ask the hunters that go to your Gurudev and ask him how he is merciful, to whom you have described this shape of that person, Krishna. How he is merciful. They went returned in evening, and again they came, and they came to Vyasdev, and Vyasdev told, Aho Vakiyam Stanakanupu Jighansaya Payata Papasadhi Levhegatim Dandhatra Uchitam Kova Annam Saranam Brijim. He told that even a putana, a Rakshasi, a demon who was only jo piti thi, to drink the blood of very little boys and to take the place of all these boys. So she was so a very big demon. And she came to Krishna to eat and to drink the blood of Krishna and to make that. But even Krishna gave him salvation, not only salvation, but the gati of mother, the position of him, like a mother. How he is? So living Krishna, we should not serve any other. Only Krishna, he is so powerful and he is so merciful, there are none like this. So this try to do bhajan of Krishna. At once Sukadeva Goswami attacked to Vyasdev and came, and very lovely and affectionately she taught Sukadeva Goswami all Srimad Bhagavatam. And now he is speaking about Nigama Kalpatarur Galitam Phalam Sukamukhad Amrita Prasanjutam Pivata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Muhuraho Rishita. Srimad Bhagavat not is a book and also not of this world. She is of Golok Vrindavan, Srimad Bhagavat. It comes from Golok Vrindavan like a fruit of Nigama Kalpata. Nigamans Vaid Upanishad, Suti, Smriti, and all our ancient books. You know that the abode of all things, coming from all Vedas, Rig, Sam, Yajur, Athar, and Upanishad, these are our ancient books. But it has been told that Nigama Kalpataror Galitan Phalam, Srimad Bhagavat is the essence of, fruit of that Nigama. If anyone is practicing Vedas, doing yajna and all other things, reading Upanishad, practicing Upanishad, what is the use of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam? We should know this. Why? It has been told that there is a tree of mango tree. And very beautiful and sweet the fruit is there. We can taste the very sweet fruit. If we want to test it to choosing the root of that tree, we cannot have. Understand what I want to tell?
Chewing the root of the tree.
We cannot have that sweetness of fruit. But whole thing is tree. We cannot test that sweetness by chewing and choosing parts of tree. We cannot take this taste, sweet taste by the lips. We can have that taste in very ripened mango. So, if we go to sea, endless sea, so deep, but a bird, very little tuntunin bird, cannot save her life by drinking the water of sea. We cannot take any water from sea. If the clouds, sun, take by his rays, taking the essence of water and the shape of clouds, and he gives water, then it is so sweet in Ganges, in Yamuna, in so many rivers. And by that, we can save our life. But we cannot drink a bund, drop of water from ocean. So Vedas are like ocean of salty water. But Srimad Bhagavat is the fruit of all the Vedas. What has been told in Vedas, all Upanishads, more than that is in Srimad Bhagavatam, because it is fruit. Who brought it? Sukadeva Goswami. From where? From Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva from where? From Brahma. Brahma from where? Narayan. From where Narayan? Shankarsana. From where does Shankarsana? From Krishna himself. So Srimad Bhagavat is Krishna. So, though it is a rush like water, but it is a rush. No seed, no sparks, कोई उस पर छिलका नहीं, उसमें अठली गुठली नहीं, उसमें कोई हे अंश नहीं, nothing is there, only rush and rush. But it never फटता फूटता नहीं. Coming from Vrindavan glow so high is never broken, never, and solid, and but Sukadeva Goswami took it in his mouth, so it became more and more sweet, and he is giving to Parikshit Maharaj. So if he went to know all the Vedas, Upanishads, and essence of all these things, and to make your life successful, then you have to read Gita and Bhagavad. Gita is first book, and whereas Srimad Bhagavatam is what? Graduation book. MA, PhD book. Gita has told up to Saranagati, and Srimad Bhagavatam has told श्रद्धा निष्ठा रुचि आसक्ति भाव प्रेम स्नेह मान प्रणय राग अनुराग भाव महाभाव मोर देन दिस सो आवर लाइफ आवर our goal of the life and whole our all these things should be the love and affection towards Krishna like Brajavasi and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give this thing Braja Prem and in the same time he distributed Krishna Naam but his whole object was to give this message of pure affection and love like Brajavasi. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Krishna, took the beauty and the mode of Srimati Radhika and he added Krishna mercy plus Radha mercy. Wow, very powerful. And came to this world to give that same thing. I think that Swamiji has come only to give this thing. Then I will describe and explain what was that. We should chant Harinam, but with mood of Prem. If there is no Prem, then doing Archan of Thakurji, chanting name, will not do so much. So we should read Srimad Bhagavat Chaitanya Charitamrita in the association of very bona fide Vaishnavas and Acharya. And thus chanting Hari name, thinking that we are in Vrindavan Braja. Don't think that we are in America or anywhere. Thinking by way. If you are not following all these things, then we are self-killer. So, next class, I will try to explain something. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and what he gave and what is Srimad Bhagavatam, essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. I will try it. Prahlad Maharaj Charitra, Ajamil Charitra, Gopi Charitra, Damodar Leela and all other things. So, Gaur Premanande.
One announcement for everyone who is present here. Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj will be with us. He has just arrived today. He will be with us up until this coming Saturday. And there are three more programs scheduled for this week. The first one is on Monday at the Anand Church of Self-Realization in Palo Alto. And that is in the evening time from 7 to 9 p.m. Tuesday evening, it will be at the Finnish Brotherhood Hall on Chestnut Street in Berkeley, also 7 to 9 p.m. And on Wednesday, July 3rd, 7 to 9 p.m. at the Yoga Society at 2872 Folsom Street, San Francisco. So we have these flyers available on the back table with the addresses. And also Srila Maharaj will be with us giving darshans in the morning time where he will be residing. Anyone who wishes to come to attend his pravachan in the morning time can see us before you leave, and we will give you the address where he will be staying. Hare Krishna. There is also prasadam. We have brought prasad for everyone to take. So, where is it? At the back?
It's right here. Through this, through here, through these doors, exit doors.
Okay, through these doors here.
And to the grass area.
And also, we have some books on a book table in the rear here. Srila Narayan Maharaj's books in English language. I think we have some Hindi books also. Hello.